Hello, good evening everyone. Welcome to question series of GATE and UGC NET, and particularly we are taking linear programming problems. So let's take up the question for today. This question was asked in GATE 2020. So let's read the statement first. We have two values, two parameters, alpha and beta, both are reals, and we are given the information alpha is non-zero. So we are given a system of two linear equations having four variables, four unknowns, and all of them have to be non-negative. So this question says the system has no basic feasible solution if. So we have to choose the correct option, that for what combinations of this alpha and beta we will be in a case, in a situation when this system incurs no basic feasible solution. So first of all, we should be clear with the meaning of basic feasible solution. So this consists of two parts, basic and feasible. So basic solution means that when we are given a system of m equations and n unknowns, then only m variables, m unknowns basically, out of n have to be in the basis or the system, rest n minus m have to be put equals to 0, right? So that means, like, we have four variables here, x1, x2, x3 and x4. So out of four, at one time we will keep only two in the system and solve the rest of the system by putting other two variables equals to 0. So this is the approach to find the basic solutions. And how many basic solutions possibly may exist? 4C2, right? So that is 6, because out of 4 you have to choose 2 at a time. So there will be 6 such combinations. And these 6 basic solutions, some of them will be feasible and some of them will be infeasible. So where is this feasibility decided from? So this is decided from non-negativity. That if all the four variables take up value greater than equals to 0, then that solution is called basic feasible solution, otherwise infeasible. So let's see how to solve this and how to get the right answer. So for this, we need to first find the basic solutions, only then we'll be able to check in the feasibility conditions. So for finding the first basic solution, what I'm going to do is putting x1 and x2 in the basis. So this automatically put x3 and x4 is equal to 0. So I can see that by putting x3 and x4 equals to 0, I get my system x1 minus x2 is beta. And now you can solve this 2 cross 2 system of equations, and very easily you can see you will get the value of x2. Is beta minus 8 and x1 is 2 beta minus 8. So this is my first basic solution. Since it is turning out to be in terms of beta, I cannot comment anything about whether this x1 is positive or x2 is negative or whatever. We will see that later on. We can't simply decide the feasibility or infeasibility by looking at only one solution, because they want no BFS. That means every basic solution should be satisfying, should not be satisfying the feasibility condition. So let's figure out the second solution. So in second solution, I'm putting x1 and x3 in basis and putting x2 and x4 is equal to 0. So this gives me x1 plus alpha x3 is 8 and x1 is beta, right? So you can very easily see that. So when x1 is beta, I get x3 is 8 minus beta by alpha. So this is my second solution. So alpha is coming in the denominator, that's why it was given in the question. Alpha has to be non-zero. Still, I cannot say anything about the feasibility. So let's compute one more solution. This time put x1 and x4 in the basis and put x2 and x3 as 0. So this gives me x1 is equal to 8 and x1 plus x4 is equal to beta. This gives me x4 is beta minus 8. Now, this is my third basic solution. So here I can say something. Before this, whatever x1, x2 or whatever basic variables I was getting, they were in terms of beta and alpha, all of them. But this particular x1 is definitely free from alpha and beta, and it is coming with a value 8. So this is positive. And since my condition says that no basic solution should be feasible, so that means this x4 definitely has to be negative. So this will give me that beta minus 8 has to be negative. Beta is less than 8. So this is one condition at least I got. So this clearly eliminates a part, which says beta has to be greater than 8, because if beta has become greater than 8, then this condition of finding no basic feasible solution will not be satisfied. So now I have to choose between these three options, because if beta is less than 8, then there is a possibility that it can be less than 0 also. If it is less than 8, so there are two possibilities. It can be lying between 0 to 8, or it can lie even less than 0. So we have to clear that. So let's clear that by finding one more solution. And in this case, now I am keeping in what is the other combination? So I am keeping x2 and x3 in basis, and x1 and x4 I am putting 0. So this will give me minus 2x2 plus alpha x3 is 8. And minus x2 is beta. So this gives me x2 is minus beta. So by putting x2 is minus beta here, I get 2 beta plus alpha x3 is 8. So x3 is 8 minus 2 beta by alpha, right? This is what I get from here. So now I got four solutions, and now let's try to see the conditions. Okay, so what happens? So we have to first clear whether beta lies between 0 to 8 or beta is less than 0. So let's first see what happens if beta is less than 0. So if beta is less than 0, so you see what is going to happen? This x2 will become positive because this is minus beta. If I am assuming beta is negative, so minus beta will become positive. So x2 will become positive. And what will happen to x3? So this will be 8 minus 2 something negative by alpha. So this will be 8 minus 2 beta by alpha. And this will become positive if alpha is positive, because the numerator, as you can see, is always positive if beta is negative. So if alpha is positive, this will be positive. If alpha is negative, this will be negative. So that means, because I want this fourth solution to be negative, to be infeasible, so I want this to be negative. So that is only possible is if alpha is negative, right? So alpha is negative is lying, so if beta is negative, as you can see here, the option, if beta is negative, this is coming with an option of alpha positive. So this is completely wrong, because I just shown you that if I assume beta negative, then alpha also has to be negative. So this C option also gets eliminated, right? So possibly, right, we can be here. So now let's see what happens. Let's look at the other solutions. Okay, so this means we are in the case, okay, beta is negative and alpha is negative. So what happens here? What happens here to x3? That this 8 minus beta is definitely going to be positive, and this alpha is definitely negative. So this overall becomes negative, and this also becomes negative, because I have assumed beta is negative, right? And what happens to third solution? So that for the third solution, since beta is negative, so this x4 also becomes negative, right? Because that was also satisfied beta less than 8 beta. So that means all these becomes negative if beta is negative. So alpha negative combination is working well. But you look at this combination, that if this happens, because now everything is working well, we have to now select one of them between B and D. So if beta lies between 0 and 8, so let's see what happens if beta is positive. So if beta is in some case positive, so you will see this solution is positive, so this has to be negative, right? So for this has to be negative, so 8 minus beta is already we know is a positive quantity, because beta less than 8 is a universal truth that we derived in the beginning. So this has to be negative, right? So alpha has to be negative if beta is positive. So if beta is positive, alpha has to be negative. This is what we saw just from the second solution. So that means this option is also eliminated. We are left with only D option. So this is the correct answer. So this question is a little bit lengthier, but the concept is same. Depending upon the complexity of the question, you may need to solve sometimes less, sometimes more, but it's all about these calculations. Right? So that's the correct option. Thank you.